Sorry, folks, not sure what happened there. Our video just kind of ended. We'll let people get back in, and hopefully that doesn't happen again. Hey, Mr. Schmidt. Good, it seems like a lot of you were able to jump right back in. Not sure what happened there, guys. Our video just kind of quit on us. It looks like more people are joining in right now. Hey, Patrick. Hey, everybody. No, we did not start yet. Well, we did, and then it kind of stopped on us. So, did we officially start? No. How about that? Yeah, I'm not sure what happened. We may have been having some issues with the video feed today. So in case you missed anything, I'll just go back really quickly. If it looks like I'm reading lines here, I am. I'm not off book. I've got some notes up there. Hey, Sumer. Hey, Ranveer. Hey, Rohan. Hey, Six Family. Sorry, I'm trying to keep up with all the comments as they come in. Hey, Sydney. I just shared earlier, and I'll summarize really quickly. When we have we need some notes. It really seems like whenever we have a week like spring break where we're anticipating being off and we need a break from school, that week always goes by so fast. And this week where we weren't expecting it, we want to be at school. We want to see our friends, our colleagues, our teachers. It just seemed like the week dragged on. And the context of the situation that we're in really affects how we feel about it, which is why it's so important to stay connected with things like this or just seeing your neighbors, keeping that safe 6 feet distance between you, but still being able to check in with each other, FaceTiming your friends, doing whatever you can to keep in touch is so important right now. So thank you for visiting us here tonight. Invite other people to do the same or find things that you can do to stay connected with each other. All right, so rather than go through the whole spiel again, what we're going to do is we're going to get right into our bloopers for the night. I'm switching around screens here a little bit. I try to do a quick contest where if you can guess who this Funko Pop is, then you get to pick which bloopers we watch. It wasn't very successful. So I'm going to put him away. This is a Funko Pop from the musical Little Shop of Horrors, by the way. Obscure reference for the elementary and middle school crowd. So I think I'll just go ahead and choose... You know, we haven't done anything from 2016 yet. We watched all the 2015 movies. Mrs. Salerno, you know it because you are married to me. You have an unfair advantage. Stop cheating, please. We watched all the 2015 movies. There were no bloopers that year because we did 3 movies. We watched The Markleys. We watched Alone at School. And we watched Holiday Party. We haven't watched anything from 2016 yet. So there's the Time Turners, Field Day, and we'll watch the bloopers from those tonight. Rohan, that doesn't count. You just saw Mrs. Salerno say it. That's like the second degree of cheating. The first degree is already knowing the answer because you're married to the question asker. The second degree of cheating is hearing the question asker's wife giving the answer to the question. Anyway, we're going to watch the 2016 bloopers tonight. Bloopers from the Time Turners and Field Day. These are the first two movies we did that were actually based on other movies. Time Turners based on Back to the Future Part 2, also kind of based on Harry Potter, a little bit of Diary of a Wimpy Kid thrown in there. Field Day based on Groundhog Day, both of which are some of my favorite movies. All right, let's get started with our bloopers. We'll go back to that video at the end. All right. You're welcome. All right, here we go, folks. Again, if you can't hear or there's audio issues, just drop something in the comments and I'll fix it. So the first year, I convinced everybody that there wasn't enough time to do any bloopers. Editing took so long. Action. And then I surprised them all with bloopers on premiere night.
Teammate 2, that's your line. You start.
Oh, me?
Yep.
And then I thought, that's the first and only time I could do that. That trick's never going to work again. But you know what? It's worked every year since.
Pulmonary and reduced muscle contractions.
Camera's all rolling. Action.
Green screen that year.
When did you guys get here?
Oh, those bald caps.
That bald head.
Thanks. Don't I know it?
You should zoom in on that. You should zoom into something right here.
Yeah, well,
zoom in on something.
No. Just like
he's
that.
Always right. Don't get
excited. Hey, Nandini.
Don't get
started.
You should say, don't get us.
I will get one. Cut.
This is an
awkward
one.
I can't aim.
Hey, Mead. Hey, Elena. Just in time to see your bloopers, Elena. This is over.
Really good.
Hey, Kayla. Thanks for joining us tonight.
Cut. You'll go down in history as the greatest athlete.
I know.
It's a bloopers night.
As the school.
As the greatest. Good. All right. Nice job.
I did it. All
right. So in some of these bloopers, you're going to notice that Josh has a cast on. And in others, he does not. That's because mid-filming, he actually broke his arm, like on a day that we were supposed to film. Same with Will, I think. And we just kind of rolled with it. We had to make do what we could, and we got everything done. But it required some definite restructuring of our filming days. Hi, Kayla. Awesome movie stars, Mrs. Over, the best in the business.
Whistle. Whistle, you clown, get out of here. Mr. Stewart, give me the whistle.
Okay, Jim's over, tweet!
Mr. Stewart, can you give me the whistle?
Tweet!
How many? I had planned for one. We'll see what the group says when we're done with the first one. Yeah, this group is ninth graders now, right? Crazy.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Sorry,
from the
top. Poor Hatish. He filmed this entire movie kneeling on a stool because his character was supposed to be super short. So every time you see Hatish, he's not actually that short. He's just kneeling on a stool.
Action, go!
Mr. Salerno's favorite book making an appearance there, Coraline by Neil Gaiman.
Action.
Hey, Mrs. Moore.
Hey there, how are you, man?
I'm going to trip back to 2015. Is it really that difficult to walk?
It looks like I cut my hair then.
Yeah, it looks short.
Yeah. My hair grew a lot.
Rainbow cover is on Friendly Against Mary.
So when we filmed this, the 10th Diary of a Wimpy Kid movie had just come out, or book, rather, had just come out, and now I think we're working on 15, 16 Diary of a Wimpy Kid books.
I'm going to space on continuing
to handle
that.
Handle that.
And
handle this.
It's...
Yeah,
I really should it. I think the space time can handle
it. Space that's nice.
End of the story.
Did it again.
Keep doing that. I think the space time
continues.
I can handle that.
Okay. Clap. Everybody likes Diary of a Wimpy Kid. Everybody.
Mrs. Channing traveled back in time. Oh, wait. No, that's not what I can.
Sorry, my fault.
You know how hard it is to get fifth graders to be able to understand and explain time travel? Very. The answer there is very, very hard.
Should I let her know that I'm recording?
You know what? The Diary of Wimpy Kid books, there's not a whole lot of story there, but I reread a couple of them over the summer a few years ago.
Keep rolling.
And the way I understand it, it's like a stand-up comedy act. There's not one long story from the first page to the last, but there's a lot of fun stuff in between. So if you read it like that as an adult, if you look at it like that, it's a little bit easier to understand why kids like it so much.
Wait. Got that. Oh. Sorry, cut. I didn't mean hairy face.
Oh, Mr. Stewart.
Cut cameras.
This is my book.
Cut. Good. Give that off. Good. Okay, keep rolling.
But I just think it would work better as a movie.
Good.
I just think it would work better as a movie.
It worked, Marty. You did it.
That vest really helped make that Marty character.
Hey, Dewey. Are the cameras still rolling?
Yeah.
Okay. Cut.
All right. That's the end of bloopers from 2016. Let's get some more light on the situation here. There we go. That's better. Whoa. Hey, Josh. Hey, Jack. Thanks for joining us tonight. We just finished the bloopers from 2016? Right? 2016. Time Turners and Field Day. So I think it was a Meathead asked if how many we're doing tonight. I'd only planned for one. Let's quickly poll the audience. If you'd like to do one more. I think I've got time for one more. If you'd like to do one more blooper video, I think we've got time for that. So shoot me a comment there in the comments. Tell me your opinion. Tell me your thoughts there in the comments. If you'd like to do one more, if you think you're done for the night. Got one vote for more. Another vote for more. Mrs. Salerno apparently likes keeping me in the basement. She likes having the living room to herself. Amit says more. The Six family says more. Dami says more. A fun thing I've done today. Patrick says more. Juan, more. Ha ha. Oh, puns. This is over. Very good. All right. No matter how many more votes I think the mores have spoken. So let's see. Let's take a quick step back. And let's see, let me switch this around again. And let's see, what should we go with? I think that the 2017 bloopers would be a good one to follow up with. Oh, you could also see on here, I think I announced this in the TikTok, and which I then shared to my stories. I started adding all the rewatches to the YouTube channel as well. So again, there's a link to this on my library website, but if you go to the library website, you could link to the YouTube channel and all the rewatches we've done are there. So if you missed one or if you want to rewatch the rewatch, there you go. That's how you can do it. So let's move on. Let's go to the 2017 bloopers with the Markleys and Heart and Soul. Does that sound good to you guys? Yes, no, doesn't matter. That's what we're doing, regardless of what you think. Looks like I started watching this at one point and didn't finish. Let's rewind all the way back to the beginning. Here we go.
We don't like hair.
I mean, you had no bloopers. Your performance was absolutely flawless.
What are you doing?
Don't laugh. Don't laugh. Don't. Oh, you laughed. He enjoyed that way too much. Katie's going to be very disappointed she's not tuned in for her own bloopers. Look, Mr. Salerno used to wear his Fitbit.
Oh, I keep getting that line. No one can tell me. Okay. The last chance we'll ever get.
Guest spot by Mr. Chuck coming up.
My eyeball.
Nick knew the blocking. Might be my favorite blooper of all time. Yes, that was where I told Nick, maybe don't put your mouth on the soccer net. I mean, you really enjoyed wearing that headband, right? Hey, Peppermint family. Hey, Mr. Alice. Thanks for joining us tonight. No, I think you secretly loved it. I think that was your most favorite costuming decision ever.
No.
Okay.
No.
The
first thing to do is...
Dami, I'm just going to go ahead and assume that's a metaphor. For the choices we make in life.
Okay.
And scream. And scream.
Over actors.
You'll walk there.
Oh, do it?
Yeah, walk. Yeah, walk. Keep walking. Go.
I think Mr. Ellis has some bloopers coming up in this one. The end of round two of bloopers. There we go. I'm back. Let's get some more light on the situation here. Just scroll back. Oh no. Quiet down up there. All right. Bloopers, always a fun thing to watch. Before we go, so if you joined us late, we had started a broadcast, and then for whatever reason, we got cut off and had to come back. One of the things I shared at the top of the first broadcast was that it's so important that we stay connected, whether it's through tuning into things like this or just, you know, giving a hello to our neighbors across the street, maintaining that safe 6 feet distance, or FaceTiming with our friends, shooting your teachers an email. It's important that we stay connected. And one of the way that the KDM teachers found to stay connected was we had a meeting online yesterday, and we wanted to take the time to just make sure that all of our students know that we miss them, we're thinking about them. So we shot a quick video, which I shared online today, but want to share with you all right now. So we'll just do that, and then we'll end our show for tonight. Here we go. Quick 20-second video. Let's go full screen too. We're gonna watch it. Let's do it the right way. Pretty quick one, but again, just letting you know that your teachers are thinking about you. We hope to see you sooner rather than later, but, you know, whenever that ends up being, let's stay connected in the meantime. Hope everybody's staying home, staying safe, and most importantly, that's kind of been the theme of the night, please make sure you stay connected. We're thinking about you. Good night, everybody. Oh, no, wait, sorry, one more announcement. Way to bury the lead, Mr. Salerno. Miss Bogan's going to be going live at 9 o'clock tonight with her bedtime story. I'm going to be doing a guest spot with her tonight. We're going to do a read aloud together. We're going to test that out on her Instagram feed. So we'll still have another script to screen rewatch tomorrow night. And at 8 o'clock, and then at 9 o'clock, I'm gonna jump on with Miss Bogan, and we're gonna do a read aloud together. So tune in to one of those, both of those. Again, stay connected. All right, guys, that's it. Now I'm officially done. Have a good night. See ya.